尊敬的吴主席总裁委员，尊敬的马里总委员，尊敬的王恒总委员，尊敬的蔡茂国总委员，尊敬的各位省议员、各位市长、各位市议员，尊敬的侨界和媒体朋友们，各位嘉宾、女士们、先生们，大家晚上好。
流光溢彩，金珠去，日新月异，玉兔来。今天很高兴与大家欢聚一堂，共迎新春佳节。首先，我代表中国驻多伦多总领事馆全体同事对大家的光临表示热烈的欢迎。
刚刚过去的2019年，对中国而言是极度平凡、令人难忘的一年。我们隆重庆祝了中华人民共和国成立70周年。我们领军侨界的朋友们举办了30多场庆祝活动，以各种方式表达对祖国的 美好祝福。我们也怀着非常自豪的心情，庆祝了澳门回归祖国20周年。上个月，也是在这里，我们馆联举行了一个招待会，各界友好人士相聚一堂，共同赞美澳门特色一国两制，成功实践。
2019年，面对复杂多变的国际形势，中国顺应世界发展大势，坚定改革开放步伐，取得了一系列新成就。中国国内生产总值超过14万亿美元，人均迈上1万美元的台阶。 全国有1000多万人实现脱贫 ，5G 的商业应用加速推出，中国的 5G 专利数量已经占到全球市场的 30.3%。2019年，中国继续张开双臂拥抱世界。 我们成功主办了第2届“一带一路”国际合作高峰论坛、北京世界园艺博览会、亚洲文明对话大会和第2届中国国际进口博览会，向世界展示了一个文明、开放、包容的中国。2019年。 中国继续高举多边主义旗帜，秉持公平正义原则，积极推动构建人类命运共同体。世界上又有一些国家同中国建交，中国的建交国增加到180个，我们的朋友遍天下。 Ladies and gentlemen, the year 2020 will be a milestone. In this year, China will eradicate absolute poverty, finish building a moderately prosperous society in all aspects, and on the basis of realizing the first centenary goal, China will embark on a new journey towards the second centenary goal. In the new year, China will continue to open its market and optimize business environment. For instance, in the financial sector, the foreign equity limits in China will be gradually removed. On January 1st, the foreign equity limits of future companies was removed. On April 1st, the foreign equity limits of fund management companies will be removed. On December 1st, the foreign equity limits of securities companies will be removed. In the new year, China will remain committed to one country, two systems principle and safeguard the long-term prosperity and stability of Hong Kong and Macau. China will also remain committed to the One China principle and the 1992 consensus and press ahead with the great cause of the peaceful reunification of the nation. The year 2020 also marks the 50th anniversary of the establishment of the diplomatic relations between China and Canada. Over the past half a century, China-Canada relations have experienced ups and downs, but generally maintained a positive momentum of development. It has been proved that a sound China-Canada relationship serves the shared interests of our two countries and two peoples. Since December 2018, bilateral relations have been facing serious difficulties, which we do not want to see. It is better for the world to undo what he has done. In the new year, we hope the obstacle in China-Canada relations will be removed and all bilateral ties will go back to the right track early.
女士们, 先生们, 在过去的一年里, 领区内各界人士, 克服种种困难, 继续致力于增加友好互利合作。 特别是领区内广大侨胞留学生和中资机构人员，大家从不同角度讲述中国故事，以不同方式支持祖国建设和统一大业，支持"一国两制"伟大实践。我愿借此机会对大家所付出的辛勤努力和大力支持 表示崇高的敬意和衷心的感谢。希望大家在新的一年里继续发挥自身优势，为促进增加友好合作、深化两国人民的相互了解和友谊贡献力量。再过七天，就是 庚子鼠年春节，子鼠还在十二生肖的第一位，寅鼠贺岁，福满乾坤。所以我在这里祝大家在新的一年里事业兴旺，学业顺利，生活美满，吉祥健康。谢谢大家。
好，非常感谢韩涛总领事。Thank you, Consul General。接下来呢？ 我们有请胡子修参议员与联邦众议员们上台致辞。 Next, we would like to welcome Honorable Senator Oh and all MPs, including the just arrived Mr. Shang Chen, to the stage to say a few words, please.
Consul General Han Tao of the People's Republic of China, all representatives from the three levels of government, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. It is my great honor to bring greetings on behalf of the Senate. And I'd like to say tonight there is a special guest and dear friend of mine, the former mayor, Taser McCallum from Mississauga, soon will be celebrating her 99 years old birthday. Let's give her a round of applause. And I can say she probably is the person that is always a good friend of China. She has been traveled to China probably more than I traveled to China. Personally, I traveled with her to China for at least 5 times. And still a name of recognition. So I want to thank her that for many years they are helping building the friendship between Canada and China. With 2 million Chinese living in Canada, I would like to say in 2017, we celebrated 150 years of building this new nation. And I'd like to say Chinese in Canada plays an important role in building this country. Our contribution has been starting before it was called Canada. So I want to say thank you to all the Chinese community that from here now and before, that thank you for your contribution.